بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Today we're going to talk about the lab form that we use in Just University. And this lab form is considered specific for removable partial dentures, where you write down your information as a student and the technician's and the patient's name. And you also put in the information about the case you have in terms of kinetic classification, the modification, and the support types that we need. In it, you have to specify the teeth you have extracted, and then you have to specify the abutment teeth, the rests, where are they going to be placed, the connectors, minor connectors, major connectors, also about the retainers, the indirect retention, and then you're going to put in detail the plan for teeth preparation. For each tooth, you're going to specify all procedures that are going to be done on it. And you also put on some of the results from the surveying process, where you put the undercuts suitable for the cases. Some of the clinical findings are also put in this form, where you note anything interfering with your RPD components on the abutment teeth. As well, you check the casts in their articulated form. And finally, you put some of the findings from the surveying that might cause an interference in a removable partial denture procedure. The drawing in the middle gives you the design area, where it specifies the upper and the lower. So we're going to go through the sequence. So we're going to go through the sequence here, and we're going to begin doing the lab procedure for our own lab cases that we have used throughout the course. You remember that we have provided you with upper and lower casts that have Kennedy classification 2 mod 1. So I'm going to fill in the lab form in detail, showing the sequence, how you do it, and this is requested from you to be repeated in your design homework. So we have multiple designs, and these are advanced designs because they have some rules and they have some conditions that we have written. So you have to apply these methods in filling in the forms, and this will also be the way we're going to use in the exam. So first, we begin by wiping away, but using the Tippex or corrector, the areas where the saddles we have. And we do it in the upper because we have two casts. We're going to also do it in the lower. Wiping away using white corrector the teeth that are not present in the patient's mouth. Also, these teeth are the ones planned for extractions. In the lower, we have a bounded area and we have a free and saddle area. After we have done that, we have to state finally what is the Kennedy classification of the case. And we depend here for the Kennedy classification on the most posterior saddle area. Then we specify the number of modifications, other saddle area, bounded saddle areas in that position. And we also need to state the type of support. The type of support is dependent on the number of missing teeth or the type of saddle. Free and saddles have type 2 tissue support, and the modification areas, if they are bounded, they have, which they are always bounded, they have tooth support area unless they are large. So we fill in the modifications, and then we begin putting in as well the teeth that are selected as abutments, because not all the teeth around the saddles are usually those in abutments. And then we're going to use colors to fill in the rest of the components. In the following video, we'll see it step by step, how do we draw the colors and how do we fill the form. So let's begin by stating the Kennedy classification of the cases. Now here we state only one, so the upper and lower are the same. We also write down the teeth that are missing, and we put on the areas where teeth are need support. We add in the saddle areas, we draw the resin retention areas, we add our rests to the teeth that we need to put rests on. We're going to verify their location a bit better later on, and then we make sure that we're using the correct colors. The correct colors are like a color code that is between you and the lab. So we add our rests depending on the type of the tooth. Wherever we have anterior teeth, we put. After the rests, we put now the next minor connector, which are the guide plates that are close to the guide planes on the proximal surfaces. And these are around all teeth that have a saddle area close to them. We then finalize the saddle areas with a mesh in the areas that are bounded. This was our case for learning purposes, but using a mesh or an open lattice has specific indications and contraindications. You have to go back to your theory to state that. Now, the abutment teeth that have been checked clinically are colored in yellow. This is to verify that these teeth are suitable for support. So they are colored in yellow, and those are usually those close to the saddle areas. Then we add our retention. Our retention methods differs depending on the type of the clasp. Just make sure that you draw the clasp in a way that is understandable. If it's an occlusal approaching. Here in the free and saddle, we refine the rest position because this is an RPI system, and we put our rests on the abutments on the mesial side of the teeth because this is an RPI system. And we just make a notch on the retentive arms because we need to tell the technician that this is the retentive arm, not the other one. In here, the bounded saddle here, we chose an eye bar for aesthetic reasons, as you have remembered. And now we add in the acres. This is now the acres complete. After that, we color the major connector area, and we make sure that the extensions of the connector depend on the abutment teeth posteriorly. We have an acre system, so it doesn't extend too much posteriorly. Around the mesh area, it extends a bit more palatal to the marginal gingiva of the teeth missing. On the canine, we're going to use a plate here. In the canine area, because we don't have enough clearance, we're going to make it as a plate. While in the other premolar area, in the upper, we have sufficient clearance for the premolar, so we're going to leave the margin of the gingiva open. So this is how we draw it. In the lower, we're going to use the lingual bar as our main basic choice for our design. The lingual bar is extended around the mesh area in a perpendicular manner. A plate is extended to the abutment, which is the canine. And the lower premolar, the first premolar does not have sufficient buccolingual width, so we have chosen a plate. And we finalize and draw clearly the finish area between the major connector and the reserve retention area. So we need to make it clear for the technician that there is a finish line. Now we draw the finish lines in a more clear manner so the technician will recognize them. The finish lines, of course, give enough clearance for the teeth to be replaced. So that's obvious in the drawing, and it will also be practiced once the technician finishes the work. In the upper, we're also going to put the finish lines. In the free and saddle, we extend the finish line up to the hamular area. This is where the denture will be, acrylic will be extending. Finally, after you finalize your drawing, following the colors that have been stated, please label all components of your design. Why do you need to label them? So the technician will not miss any of them. So make sure that all components of your design are labeled. And then we're also going to do it for the lower. Labeling everything, even minor, for example, even in the ICARS system, we're going to label the retentive arm alone and the reciprocal arm alone as much as possible, not crowding the image. So we're not going, we are labeling all components, but we can use numbers or codes to specify the names of, we don't have to write the full name, not to crowd the design image. After we finish that, we're going to state each teeth, what are we going to do. So first we're going to do the upper teeth, and we're using the numerical system that that identified quadrants. So we specify the teeth that we have to alter, not to forget any tooth. And then we're going to write in detail for each tooth what are the preparations. Wherever we have a comma, that means we have more than one preparation on the tooth, and we will not forget to open the embrasure for the minor connector. Here, just an extra added about the rests. I'm going to make sure that I add all rests correctly after I finalized my design, that the rests are clearly stated in my support. Here we need to add more rests if we need indirect retention or auxiliary rest. So this is how we fill the form. We kindly ask that you fill in the form paper separately for each design you have in your homework and submit it before next week, before the lab next week. Thank you. After the rests, we put now the next minor connector, which are the guide plates that are close to the guide planes on the proximal surfaces, close to the saddle areas.